We came from a single cell organism, and then we became a monkey. And they say that this is where we came from, right? You want to believe them, right? It sounds fascinating, doesn't it? We used to be like apes to walk around in trees and whatnot. One day we became men.
You want to cry out to God, but because you
you have this hate in you because this person did you what and whatnot, and because you feel like, well, I know I'm not right now, God won't hear me, but you know what? He will hear you. He will see you through those times. He will give you what you need to persevere. He will give you all that you need from him. You just got to sing. You got to give him your all. You got to give him the glory that he rightfully deserves. I heard Pastor Butner ask a question last week. He said, is it better to have love than lies? Like, oh yeah, I love God. I love a lot of people around me. And if I lose them, it would hurt, wouldn't it? It would hurt. When you lose somebody, it hurts, right? But when they come back, it's like double love, you know? It's like some people, when they go to divorce, they get a double, and everything's cheering for them. Oh yeah. Before they get their coffee, they're praying, and as soon as they get that double, they're like, hey, how you doing? So, back to John 3:16. If God did not love us so much, he would not have given us his son, am I right? Now you're telling me that God, he loved us so that he gave us his son, right? So his son that was perfect, he was holy, he came down here, and he did all that he did for us, right? And then he died, right? He was gone for about 3 days, right? That's what scripture said, right? And then this guy came back. He rose from the dead. Wow. Like, he came back. If I was gone,
I'd go my son in the back. Thank you.
My son just came back. I don't know where he was because light and dark can't mix, but he's back. And I'm thankful that he's back. Thank you. Oh my God. God is so good. Before I close, I have one more thing to point out. I just saw the Passion of Christ last week. I don't know, I really didn't get around to it, right? And I watched it, and I seen more or less, I think, how God was treated, how Jesus was treated when he was on the face of the earth, right? They beat him. The part I had to turn away was, and I don't usually turn away from like gore and stuff. I'm like, I'm bad. I'm bad. They took a whip, they pushed on the side, and that stuff. Savior was fortune for us so that we could have a chance of everlasting life.
Amen.
Oh my. Oh my. And then the cross, and then the vinegar and the gall. I've tried to drink vinegar before. I don't know why, but I've tried it. Just came right back up. So I don't know how he could handle that, you know, like even with gall. But he did. And then when you think that was all over, right? It's like, okay, they nailed spikes in his hand, they nailed him to the cross. That pain is unspeakable. Unspeakable. I think I can handle pain more physical than emotional. And handle that emotional stuff, you know, like that. But you're like, okay, he's on the cross now. He's fine. Right? But no, he suffered even more. I don't know if you guys know this, but when Jesus was on the cross, science will tell you this. When you have your hands like this stretched out, you're not breathing properly. Your chest cavity is in such a way that when you breathe, the moisture is not being let go out of you. So in turn, he was there suffering some more. He was actually drowning at the cross. Drowning. That's why when they pricked him in the side with the spear, that's why water came out. You're telling me this perfect being came on earth and did all of this for us. Suffered so much. And then they left him to drown. Wow. God is good.
Hallelujah.
These are my final words.